driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
What kind of future does music have if it doesn't look to its past? Well, I say the question speaks for itself. Here on Second Moon, we know you can't move forward unless you keep both eyes steadily trained on what's behind you.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human psyche.
Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
This just in from traffic. If you're thinking about hitting the streets, you can expect delays on the major roads, especially during rush hour.
Good to know, Jim. Seems like everyone is in a hurry to get somewhere fast. It's worth slowing down. And if you can, plan your trip outside the rush.
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather wait an hour in traffic than to have to start thinking about everything all the time. Besides, if I did that, I'd never get anywhere.
Thank you. We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin. The Fire and Rescue Service reports that fires are currently spreading in the nearby forest. The billowing clouds of smoke pose a serious health risk to anyone nearby. At this time, all citizens in the affected area are instructed to immediately move to a safe distance until the situation is under control.
Thank you.
That was truly superfluous. Masterful counterpart, you're listening to Second Moon Radio, the station of levitated tastes. Don't touch that dial.
Our story this hour, Kim is unseen outside an abandoned building.
That's right, Jim. This decaying shell is a symbol of the industrial decline sweeping the city. People are being laid off. The industrial sector is on the verge of collapse. And worryingly, crime is on the rise.
Thanks, Kim. Always gotta watch out for crime, not to mention collapsing buildings. We'll have more after this.
For our feature story, we're on the streets with Kim this hour, taking the pulse of the city. So, Kim, what's the word on the street? Tell us what you're hearing.
It's more what I'm smelling, Glenda. I have to say, it just plain stinks around here. Gross. And these concerned citizens agree.
That's hardly news. There hasn't been any trash collection for who knows how long. There's rotting food, dirty diapers, fish guts, and... Oh, God, I can't stand to think about it, let alone smell it. And the piles of filth just keep growing and growing and growing and growing.
Can it, Eugene? We're not doomed.
You heard it here, folks. We're not doomed. It's still pretty stinky, though.
That's good to hear, Kim. We'll be back after this.
Thank you. Thank you.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin.
The Fire and Rescue Service reports that fires are currently spreading in the nearby forest. The billowing clouds of smoke pose a serious health risk to anyone nearby. At this time, all citizens in the affected area are instructed to immediately move to a safe distance until the situation is under control.
A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive, and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're tuned in to Second Moon, the channel where the classics never grow old.
For our feature story, we're on the streets with Kim this hour, taking the pulse of the city. So, Kim, what's the word on the street? Tell us what you're hearing.
It's more what I'm smelling, Glenda. I have to say, it just plain stinks around here. Gross. And these concerned citizens agree.
That's hardly news. There hasn't been any trash collection for who knows how long. There's rotting food, dirty diapers, fish guts, and... Oh, God, I can't stand to think about it, let alone smell it. And the piles of filth just keep growing and growing and growing and growing!
Can it, Eugene? We're not doomed.
You heard it here, folks. We're not doomed. It's still pretty stinky, though.
That's good to hear, Kim. We'll be back after this.
We're live, and we're getting reports about a traffic accident somewhere in the city.
Road maintenance services have already been dispatched, and traffic flow should return to normal. But if you're planning a quick trip out, you might want to wait a little while until everything clears up.
If you're in it, you already know about it. No use reminding you. Meanwhile, expect delays and drive safe.
Thank you.
A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive, and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
This is Second Moon with J. Thomas Hornbuckle. Before we dive into our next selection, I'd like to take a few memento moris to elaborate on the formal structure of the symphonic work. For our newer, less able listeners, first, we will be dancing through the al dente section before entering the slower largo movement, finally, then savoring the vivacious antipasto movement. So, without further ado, let's raise the curtain and begin.
This just in from traffic. If you're thinking about hitting the streets, you can expect delays on the major roads, especially during rush hour.
Good to know, Jim. Seems like everyone is in a hurry to get somewhere fast. It's worth slowing down. And if you can, plan your trip outside the rush.
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather wait an hour in traffic than to have to start thinking about everything all the time. Besides, if I did that, I'd never get anywhere. And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Jarva Mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this.
Thank you.
driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're listening to Second Moon Radio with J. Thomas Hornbuckle, and we're pervading some of the finest classical music on the air. Keep that dial right here.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human
psyche. Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
This just in from traffic. If you're thinking about hitting the streets, you can expect delays on the major roads, especially during rush hour.
Good to know, Jim. Seems like everyone is in a hurry to get somewhere fast. It's worth slowing down. And if you can, plan your trip outside the rush.
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather wait an hour in traffic than to have to start thinking about everything all the time. Besides, if I did that, I'd never get anywhere.